Hi, I'm Spencer with a Tennis Warehouse shoe review. This is the Wilson Tour Spin 2. An update to the Tour Spin, the Tour Spin 2 provides plush comfort straight from the box. Reactive gel inserts in both the heel and forefoot offer excellent cushion, while a mesh upper provides plenty of ventilation. Let's check in with our testers to see what they had to say about this lightweight performance offering from Wilson. We're here with Granville Swope. Gran, you're a fan of the Wilson rackets. Do the shoes match?
These shoes do. They fit me right out of the box, no break-in, and I'm going to hit the high points here. One, took the insoles out, put my orthotics in with ankle braces, still plenty of room. Lace it up, nice tight fit all the way around. Nice low ride on the court. Some big pluses, nice sticky outsole. Felt like I got great traction on the court, was able to move. And lightweight material, so they're under a pound on my foot. That's my cutoff for a good shoe, weight-wise anyway. And it was my shoe of choice at a recent tournament, so I'm very pleased with this shoe. I'll play with it till it wears out.
We're here with Jason Huang. Jay, what did you think of the Tour Spin 2?
Well, I'll agree with Gran on a few points. I thought it was really, really comfortable. It's a great shoe to just kind of walk around and kick it in. And ventilation was great as well. But that's kind of where it ended for me. I thought the support was really lacking. It just felt like the material on the upper would give a lot, and so I just didn't feel comfortable going all out in the shoes. My feet were moving around too much within the shoe, and then once I would stop and try to plant, my feet would kind of get moved outside of the base of it. So it was just a shoe that I thought was really comfortable. I would love to walk around all day in them, just not a shoe that I would play in.
We're here with Ryan Shanley. Ryan, you've had a chance to play with plenty of shoes. How does the Tour Spin 2 stack up?
They were a little disappointing for me. Right out of the box, I felt that they're pretty comfortable and had a lot of cushion. But as soon as I started to play pretty seriously on the court, I started to discover that the durability was not quite there, especially on the toe box. I wore through it pretty fast. The support was also kind of an issue for me. I did not feel comfortable moving back and forth, changing position or anything like that. I felt like the material was a little too soft. And like Jason, I had it give a little bit a couple times. So that was kind of a big concern for me. It was nice and ventilated. It was nice and light. So it had some good points, but ultimately the shoe didn't quite measure up for me.
We're here with Chris Edwards. Chris, what did you think of the Tour Spin 2?
Ventilation was great. Comfort was great if I was just walking around in it. As soon as I stepped on the court, pretty much ended right there. As you know, some of the other guys have mentioned, really, really no support and stability in the shoe. The upper material is way too soft and flexible. There's no real chassis there. There's a bit of a shank, but it's just not enough to protect my arch to make the shoe flex in the right places. So it's flexing in the wrong places. One positive was traction. The outsole is very traction oriented. It's not durable, but the stick is excellent. You know, I really felt the shoe hook up well on the court. But you know, my feet were sliding around, and not because the uppers weren't wrapping my feet snugly. I found the fit to be good. It was just that they were so soft that, you know, as Jay mentioned, my foot would actually come off the edge of the midsole and outsole, and the shoe would kind of balloon out in the upper. And so on a lateral plan, you know, an aggressive one, the top of the shoe would just keep moving. So yeah, not a shoe I felt safe in for my ankles, and a little disappointed, really.
I also play tested the Tour Spin 2, and like many of the other play testers, I'd have to agree, the positive points, definitely the comfort right out of the box. It's slipper-like. The upper is very ventilated and supple. The cushioning is fantastic. However, when you get onto court, there are some issues with stability. Like the other guys said, one thing I noticed moving laterally is my little toes would come off. As soon as I would plant, my little toes come off the base of the shoe, which I found to be an issue and which scared me, quite frankly, which made me not go or plant as hard as I normally do. Although traction was a good thing, like Chris had mentioned, durability was an issue. All in all, it wouldn't be my first choice in a tennis shoe. So all in all, it's a comfortable shoe, but it doesn't really work for the serious tennis player. That wraps it up for this edition of the Shoe Review. Check our website, tenniswarehouse.com, where you can find all kinds of information. Thanks for joining us.